Dead Island 2 takes players on a vibrant journey through sunny Los Angeles.
I'll check the other side.
During the day, the visuals are dazzling and intense, with bright colors and warm temperatures. And when night falls, the landscape is awash in neon lights, illuminating a stunning scene for zombie slaying. It's truly something. Though its most stunning visual feature lies in its animation of claw, hair and dismemberment physics being brutally grotesque and fascinating to watch in-game as gross as it is. There is some ghosting of the image at times due to TAA, but it's negligible. Chromatic aberration is used when taking damage so it doesn't hurt the overall presentation. At times SSR works, but at this point, I would prefer a toggle to turn it off on consoles. It can be distracting, especially seeing floating hands in the reflections. The environment is full of the sounds of zombies moaning and groaning. You can hear them crawling through vents and reverberating through the environment. It's a constant reminder of the danger that surrounds you. You never know when one of them will pop out and try to attack you. Indoor gunfire can be intense, with an increased reverberation compared to outdoors. However, the sound of bats breaking bones, swords slicing through their targets and hammer smashing enemies can create a satisfying auditory experience when destroying zombie hordes. Throwing a melee weapon in basic combat can result in sporadic patterns of accuracy. Some throws may fly up to 100 yards, while other throws barely make it a few feet. This discrepancy has created the perception that the mechanic is broken. Zombies can be eliminated in a variety of ways, such as dropkicking, ground pounding and screaming. Fire, acid and electrical shock are also effective methods and fun for destroying them. The biggest issue is skill cards and Fury mode. In the original games, each Slayer had a unique Fury mode that is not really the case in Dead Island 2. All Slayers generally feel the same. Performance is satisfactory with a few exceptions, including Venice Beach and Ocean View being the worst culprits. Dead Island 2's narrative can be briefly entertaining but takes a backseat to the action and mayhem. While many characters are interesting, some may prove too annoying, especially at Venice Beach. The true hero of the story and the most endearing character is Patton, an agoraphobic hermit living in the sewers, who really gives the story heart, and has quickly become one of my favorite supporting characters in video games. Make sure you revisit him and listen to his dialogue. The Slayers are all interchangeable with their own quips, but they do not affect any change to the overall narrative. Final grade: B.